he and I went against two better golf.
Can't play against somebody who hasn't met one.
I've been reduced to about a one golf game a year now. With visiting time, I'd rather be on a horse than golf course.
Simi.
I get just as annoyed with a bad shot as if it was hitting every game. Galloping in at full speed, and maybe he had a sore mouthed horse or something, I don't know, but when he turned on the reins, that horse put on all four, and he went right over the horse's landed on his feet, still holding the reins in his left hand, and was facing the two generals, and he went into a salute. And I must say, the visiting general, very slowly and deliberately responded, but as he was doing so, turned the Omaha commander and said that he always dismount this way. Promise not to give to Canadian rats.
Mr. President, does the Brezhnev remarks offer any hope?
Well, now, we don't take questions at a press conference. Photo opportunity here, but yes, I think he agreed that we'd meet. We will.
When?
We don't take questions.
Right, thank you.
Nice try.
$600 billion. Thus, we're not dealing with something that's an extension of historic precedent. We're dealing with a real crisis in the budget situation. And that's why the press, and thus he has endorsed a compromise measure that the Senate Budget Committee is $1 billion. $48 billion is still a lot of money. At least we're going in the right direction and have hopes to really bring things back into the responsible thing to do to fill that budget deficit. And the President has proposed finding about $40 or $50 billion of loopholes to close. He compromised with the Senate.
Hello. And I know you've all been sworn in, and congratulations. I don't know why you would probably kick me for it. I've given you the job, but...
Sid Kaplan, Mr. President.
Good to see you.
Carol
Hi.
Fraser,
oh, yes.
Nice to,
nice to see you.
From Illinois, bringing Carrie Rabs.
Hey, just saw her on that last trip.
That's right.
Lovely.
I know that I've seen all these fellows that are on my staff before, but I shake hands just to make sure they're still who they
are.
Just say a few words then, whatever time I have left in here before someone drags me out, but we'll have a little dialogue if possible. First of all, I want to thank you all for doing this, and it's so good to sit in here with contemporaries, using what he wants at any given time. And Caesar had a remark too that comforts me very much when he said that age. If it was not for the elders correcting the mistakes of the young, the state would soon collapse. So I figure that's what we're here to do, is to save it. But I know there are many problems that are of concern, and I'm delighted to have the opportunity to have your counsel and advice on those matters, and look forward to working with you on it. I think there are a couple of points. There's been so much demagoguery that if it wasn't for the funny papers, I wouldn't look at the paper in the morning. If you haven't mentioned Social Security yet, which I know is a concern to many people out there, have been, and I get so frustrated at those people of demagogue and frightened people into thinking that maybe they're not going to get this benefit, which they're counting on. We know that the program is insolvent. We know it has to be repaired. But I have said it has got to be repaired in a restructuring that does not take away from the people that are presently dependent on it. You can't pull the rug out from someone like that.